Hello, thank you for the introduction. And I'm pleased to be here. And now I will tell you a little bit more about the certification of the compostable and bio-waste products. We already heard this morning about some of the applications which are possible. We heard yesterday about the strategies and the developments in different countries. So one of the topics which then need to be addressed as next is how to show that your product is different to the conventional plastic. And one of the options you have is a certification and to use a logo which shows that your product is different and it's tested to show that it's different. Today, first, I would like just shortly show you who is the DIN-CERTCO, what are we doing? And then I would like to skip to the certification of the different biopolymers, because in the meantime, the certification is more than just a seedling for industrial compostability. In the past years, a wide variety has been established for different types of bioplastics and biomaterials. Just the DIN-CERTCO is already in business for more than 40 years, and was founded in 1972. Since 1997, the certification of the compostable products with the seedling mark is in place. So it's already a mark which is well established, which is in many countries already well known. Since 2010, there's also a certification in place for bio-based products. We already heard about the difference this morning and yesterday. And since this year, more other alternative certification schemes are in place. But who are we? Yeah, I know a certification body is something which is very different to the companies who do either the research or, on the other hand, who do the manufacturing of those products or the development of new materials. We are a certification body, so for us, that we are neutral, qualified, and independent is our main business, is our basis for all our services we are offering. DIN-CERTCO belongs to the TÜV Rheinland on one hand, and to the German Institute for Standardization, the DIN, on the other hand. What do we do? Just certification. We do not do any laboratory testing because it's part of the company's philosophy to have a separation between the laboratory testing on one hand and the certification on the other hand, because it's important to show we are independent. We have different types of certification, products, which is of interest for you, but also services or enterprises or even persons or systems can be certified. All these certification schemes are publicly available, and if you are interested in knowing more, you can have a look to our internet presentation. But let's go back to what is a certification and what does it mean. There's a, let's say, quite simple definition what certification is. You can see it over here. Certification means that an independent third party confirms in a written form with a certificate that a product, system, or service fulfills defined requirements. The benefit for you is when having such a certificate in hand for your product that you can show to your customers you have shown that the characteristics you are claiming are really checked, assessed, and you are conforming to the requirements. I already mentioned that all these things or the requirements are defined in a certification scheme. So you may wonder, what is it? A certification scheme states the requirements for certification and or registration. It is the basis for our certification product process, what we call the assessment. It defines how long is such a certificate valid, how does verification testing go, what do you need to do if your certificate needs to be extended or renewed, what do I need to do then? It shows all the organizational and formal aspects, and if necessary, it defines additional technical issues which are not clearly defined in standards. So, as a first step, now let's come to this to the certification schemes. I think most of you, or maybe all of you, already know this mark, the compostable mark, the so-called seedling. The basis for this certification is the European standard EN13432. This is a must. But in case you wish to sell it in other countries or you have a specific application and someone asked to show proof that one of the other standards, which in fact are very similar, is met too, you can additionally certify according to the American standard ASTM D 6400 or to another European standard, the EN 14995, which mainly refers to plastics, or to the ISO 17088, if you need something to show at international level. So we already spoke about a lot about biodegradability and disintegration in the past 1.5 days. So you may wonder, what requirements are there? What does it mean to be biodegradable or to disintegrate according to the standard? So biodegradability means the conversion into CO2 and water by means of microorganisms under compostable conditions. You need to show that in 180 days, more than 90% of your product is biodegraded. As a next step, you need to show that during a composting process, more than 90% disintegration is achieved. And according to the standard, disintegration means it must break down in the composting process by means of biodegradation into pieces smaller than 2 millimeters, and this must fit for 90% of the product. Furthermore, to show that the product is okay for a composting process, it will not harm the characteristics of the compost or the plant growth. An additional test is made, which check the germination rate and the biomass of two different plant species. Here you compare the characteristics of the compost with a polymer and the compost without a polymer. And you need to show that you have at least 90% germination rate and biomass compared to the compost without material. Furthermore, there are very strict limit values in the EN13432 for heavy metals and other toxic substances which need to be met too. Now, I would just like to show you a little bit about the specific things of the certification. Because for our certification, we made a difference between those products which are sold to the consumer, so which go into the market, packaging, or a bottle, or a film, a label, all these things which are finally designed and which goes finally into the market. This is what we call a product and what can be certified. Such things can be labeled with a seedling mark to show the conformity. But there are a lot of intermediate steps which are between the initial manufacturing of a material and the final product. So to minimize the necessity of testing, it's possible to register materials. It's a resin, for example, which can later on be used. Such material is not certified. We call it a notification of registration, what you get. You can use it to show to your customers that this is already tested and has shown conformity with these requirements. The same applies for intermediates. These are, for example, foils, semi-finished items. The same applies too for additives like inks or master batches or processing agents. It can also be fibers, which can be registered and can as such show that that the requirements of the standard are already met, that you already did testing, and that your customers are on the safe side when using this. I already mentioned that in the certification scheme, it is clearly defined how long does those certificates or notifications of registration are valid. For products, since many years already, it's a validity of 3 years. For materials, intermediates, and additives, now it's 6 years. In the past, they were valid for an undefined time, but we made bad experience with it, so we changed it to say a material, an intermediate, or an additive that has a validity of 6 years. Afterwards, a renewal can be made to extend it for another 6 years. So now you may see something which is, let's say, a bit newer for you, because since this year, we offer an additional certification for industrial compostable products. You can see this logo here because it's the DIN-SEADCO-owned certification mark, which is quite well established on the market in different applications. Now we can issue this for industrial compostable films too. You may now wonder, why do we need an additional logo? We already have a seedling mark. But we used this mark to add some alternative standards which might be requirements from the market. So we added the ISO 18606 to the certification scheme. So in case your customers on international level, for example, ask for a certification according to this standard, this certification may help you. Furthermore, we added a certification according to the Australian standard 4736. So in case you wish to ship something to the Australian market, this can be a big benefit to you. The other requirements of the certification scheme for the seedling mark are the same, just those two additional options. So far we have spoken about industrial compostable products or materials, but what we identified as a very difficult topic on the market is the testing of additives. You may have a material which is already quite well tested and registered, but as soon as, for example, you start to print on, you may run into difficulties and into additional testing. To avoid that, we established a certification scheme for additives according to EN 1342, which mainly shall deal with things like master batches and printing inks. So as soon as your supplier of inks, for example, can show you this certification, and together with the information about the maximum usable amount of the ink, you can use these inks added to a certification, and then without additional testing, you can go through the certification process. Oops, sorry, wrong direction. We have designed the certification scheme for different applications. So on one hand, for the non-biodegradable additives, like water-based inks or solvent-based inks, but also for biodegradable additives. This can be master batches, can be color batches, can be adhesives, so many different things. For all these certifications you have seen up to now, we have a list of laboratories which are approved by the INSEADCO and which can do those testing for you, just as an overview. You can see here we have the laboratories in many different countries, and it's up to you then to choose which of the laboratories you wish to cooperate with. So, as already mentioned, since 2010, we offer the certification for bio-based products. We already learned compostable polymers, it's one option, but sometimes compostability is not a topic, but nevertheless, it's bio-based. So we established the certification for those products where bio-based is a topic. So the question, where does the material is made from? Where is your product made? What is your product made from? Here we do not talk about what can you do with product after use. So no information about compostability is given here. We just talk about the content and the bio-based percentage of this product. To do this testing, we refer to an American standard. It's the ASTM D6868. We have two testings which are required. On one hand, we check the total organic carbon, on one hand, and on the other hand, we use the 14C amount of the product to identify the amount of renewable recent carbon in the final product. Based on this, we can make a distinction based on the percentage of the bio-based content for three different logos. So, depending on the percentage of 14C, you can have a certification for bio-based content of 20 to 50%, of 50 to 85%, or if you have a very high content of more than 85%. Together with the certification, the license to use one of these three logos is issued. Those certificates are valid for 5 years, and a verification testing is made every second and fifth year during the validity of the certification. This is a quite important topic because during a validity of a certification, it's important that you still have the same, let's say, characteristics as your product had at the very beginning of the certification. Okay, now we already learned about the existing certifications which are already on the market for a longer time. But as I mentioned before, the seedling mark and the DIN geprüft industrial compostable refers to industrial composting plants. So you need to have a certain recovery system in the country. You need to have the acceptance by the authorities from which are responsible for the composting that they accept those materials in their, let's say, waste stream. An alternative, which could be of interest for those areas where home and garden composting is more of interest, we established a new certification, which started in May this year. It deals with the home compostability of the materials. This certification is based on the Australian standard 5810. It deals with similar characteristics as the other standards mentioned before for the industrial compostability, so ultimate biodegradability, disintegration, the plant toxicity test, the chemical analysis. But then there's an additional test which is required here. It's the earthworm toxicity testing according to the American standard E1676. It's in addition what needs to be performed here. Now you can see a similar slide to the one I have shown you for the seedling mark certification. But as you can see here, the time frame has changed. Furthermore, the temperature which is used to perform the testing is much lower because now we have no more industrial conditions. We have the conditions in your garden, so much lower temperatures. So much more time is needed because processes are slower. And then you may now wonder, okay, now I have a big variety of different certifications and out of a sudden you may have a product which conforms to all these things, home compostable, industrial compostable, and in addition it's bio-based too. Then you may wonder, okay, now I have a small product with a huge number of different logos I need to show. So we have thought about that and decided, okay, let's make one logo with claims beside it. So that with one logo you have in the near future the option to show different characteristics. So as soon as you have different certifications of your product, you can have this alternative logo, which I would like to show you here, and which can be used then to, it's an option which will be start to be on the market soon. So you may wonder, why do I need an additional logo? Okay, on one hand, you get everything on one from one certification body, so no need to contact a huge number of different certification bodies, start everywhere at zero, send the same information to another instance two or to another company. You have an easier option. Instead of showing a huge number of different labels, you just show one. Here you can see a little bit the way it was developed. The beginning with a compostable mark with a seedling, then the bio-based certification, the industrial compostable mark, and then at the end of all these new developments, you can have now one logo which can be applied for all the different things. Furthermore, as mentioned at the beginning, independency and transparency is very important for the INSERTCO as a certification body. So as soon as you are interested in, for example, developing a product which is made of compostable or bio-based materials, you can have a look at to our internet presentation, because there you find information about all the certificates we have. The valid ones are shown there. They are daily updated. So as soon as you identify your supplier on the list, it's easier for you to get the certification, because then you know testing is already made and you can refer to their already done testing. You can find some additional information there, like the thickness the material is registered at, or for the additives, you find the maximum usable amount of the additive. So, last but not least, if you have some questions, you can, of course, contact me now at the conference, but if this doesn't work, you can contact us by email, or you can give us a call, and we can assist you in organizing your certification process.
Thank you, Julia. Have any questions to Miriam? Before I will give you mic, let me comment. Yesterday, as a kind of result of our yesterday sessions of the conference, some of us agree to create a bio, we should say it on that way. Okay, perhaps it will be better to say, to create a network of the national focal points related to bioplastics. And in some countries in Europe, already the process of the legislation of the compostable polymeric material has been finished, and in these countries, the situation is quite easier and transparent. These materials, these products are just certified and used as a certified biodegradable plastics. In some countries, however, this is under the way, and in some, in Europe, the situation is before the legislation. Is that correct?
Difficult to answer. I think it really depends on where you are and on which topic. There's not a uniform European legislation.
Yes, this is another story. Despite whether you certify that, whether some other institution will do it, from the point of view of the customer, this is important to have on the market something which is indicated and certified that it fulfills the requirements. Therefore, I think that one of the challenges for those who will create a focal point in the countries where the legislation of that kind do not exist now is to try to make some attempts to promote the national legislation of this kind of materials. Let's hope that it will be, that will be one of the result of the Plastice project. And now, Ivana, it's okay? You have no questions. Any other questions or comments? If not, thank you very much, William.
It was a pleasure.